Afternoon all. I'm about to do some work on my PC up here, so I do need to give myself a bit of room. I'm just letting that turn off, because I'm going to try to install this one, which is an IDE style, just to see if that will solve my blue screening issue. I do apologise for the wind in the background. Calling it Storm Doris, and she's hitting pretty well at the minute. We've got trees down in the area, naturally. You know, it's not surprising, it was kind of expected. Right, I'm going to see if I can find something just to dust the top of my case down while I'm at it. Right. So you want to get some extra bit of light as well. The only problem is I'm going to be in the bloody way, aren't I? Let me just get this side cover off. I'll try and keep out of the shot as much as possible. Screws. I just got to flick that. I may actually go and get my vacuum cleaner and whatnot, just give this dust over as well. So I'll slide that. Ugh. A bit dusty. Somewhere behind me, actually, I've got a dusting brush. I actually forgot that this case has got the by the way, this is why you shouldn't put your computers on the floor. There's just so much freaking dust in here. It wasn't that long ago that I dusted all this either. I dusted this completely out not so long ago. You don't want to spin your fans up either. As tempting as it is to go like that with your fans, don't. Because they generate electricity when you do that, and that can feed back into your board. And if there's enough, it could cause some damage, so I would avoid doing that. Absolutely chock full. I'm actually hoping it won't get as dusty as quickly up here. I don't know if that's coming up on camera. Maybe I'll be able to see my blue fan a little bit better now. No, shall I? I think I will. Just wait there a second. The question is, can I get this past you without knocking the tripod over? It's a good question. I'm struggling, but I think I've done it. Good old Henry back. panel off on this. That's just as filthy. You know, I figured while I'm here, might as well do all this. And just, you know, get the crud off. Absolutely caked everywhere. Here we go again. I'm actually watching the dust get sucked in from the air. I think that'll do. Now, what I need to do is get this end in the board first. They will only go in one way. It goes in like that. This is easy enough, you just slide it straight in the front. Like so. Flip the lock down, holds it in place. Again, this cable will only go one way up. And we need a power supply, which is easy. We can use the one that I've got lying in the bottom here. What I wouldn't give to have a modular power supply. So I don't have to keep using all these epoxy cables. Right. That plugs in like that. We're good to go. It's as simple as that. We are now good to go. Oh, while I've got this open. Show you why I can't put this baby in here. Reason for that is because under here, that's where my SATA ports are. That's where the video card is. So if I put the one on the table in, my big ATI one here, it just covers straight over everything. And I wouldn't be able to use the SATA ports. So, what I'd need is an actual ATX, because it's a micro ATX, or whatever they're called, the smaller version. So when I get another motherboard, that's what I'll be getting. Well, that's what I'll be putting in the other case anyway. This one I'll get left as it is. I know it's an Nvidia, but I keep forgetting which one. See if I can just find the model number. Not on this side, I can't. On the other side, maybe. Oh, right up the other bloody end. I believe it's a 9800. But it's a pretty good video card for what it is. Anyway, let's turn it on. Let me get... It just puffed out a load of fluff from the fans. It's just funny to see this lump of fluff just go boop. Either that or I've probably just got a weird sense of humour. I could, if I want to, add fans to this. And guess what? I can actually see my blue fan on the front here a lot better now. I wonder why that looked so dim. It's because it was so full of shit. Right. Haha. You can't see my password. That's not meant to be showing me that lock screen either. It's meant to be ponies, but it hasn't changed it for some reason. I've got the usual setup with my fans on this one as well. This one sucks in, that one sucks out. That top one's blowing in. Probably could do with another exhaust fan, like on the side panel, but I haven't got another illuminated one. And I can't force the power supply on this one. 700 watt power supply, so we could probably stick another... Yeah, I could stick another fan on that one if I wanted to, but I don't have overheating problems, so... Mind you, I suppose, you know, it would prevent it. Oh, and isn't that typical? I put that disk drive on there, and the damn thing won't open. There we go. It's a bit sticky for some reason. New disk. Sort of disk kind of stick in there. Oh, well, I was going to try and install my Advent camera, so... I don't think it'll work on this one. I think it's too old. I may end up changing that. That's the other reason I didn't put the side panel back on yet. It's spinning up. But is it going to do anything? It is! It's working! It is! Hey! You son of a bitch. Get back here. And it hasn't blue screened on me. Oh, that is a brilliant. I just need to change that drive. It's actually recognised up here on the PC as well, so let's click on it. Ow! Yeah, it seems to be working. Right, so what I need to do is go and find one of the other ones that I've got. Because that disc tray's a little bit on the picky side. What I'll do, I'll just turn you off for that. Because it's going to take me a while to find one up. Right, I'm back. I've got a couple. Didn't take me as long as I thought it was going to take.
So, we'll take care of this one.
And that one. Open, slow. And that one works, it's just got a dicky tray on it. Well, that ain't good. My lights are flickering. That's not good. Got Sony one here, but the it's got some heat damage on the front there. Hang on, I can't see what I'm doing. Go away. See, this came out of a shop fire. What was it? A computer that came out of a shop fire? I should say. Ooh. I've got to put the jumper on. If I can get the jumper off. I've got it. It's the only one on there, so we'll set this as master. This works, and I can do away with the USB one. You already know it works. I've just got to find a drive. That works. Seriously, that's another one that doesn't fucking open. Oh, there we go. Now it does. Okay, that seems to be operating fine. If that's gonna work, then I'll leave the Sony one on there. That is a DVD writer, isn't it? Yes, as well as a CD writer, that's good. Good, I think I'm getting somewhere. As long as this doesn't blue screen when I boot it up. Don't you just love it when you mistype your password? It is actually tempting to put another fan on this case. You see, before with the SATA drives, as soon as I'd go like that, okay, that's a bit of a temperamental drive, but that can stay on there for now, I think. I'll try it for that last one, which is just a generic one, there's no brand on it. No jumper on it either. Oh dear. Oh dear. Okay. I think that's a success. I'm going to leave that at that. That does actually seem to be working now, so it's not going to be that temperamental, I'm not going to worry about it. I'll just leave it as it is. So, let's get the cables out of the way and get the side panel back on. Sweet, we'll get rid of the other one then. Right, on that note, I'm going to find something else to do and I'll be back later. Mr. Nemo is asleep. Again, he loves sleeping on the bed. Although, when I go out, he tends to jump up on my computer chair anyway. I've stacked a lot of these trays in here because they're just full of my, well, these ones are empty apart from one. These ones are the ones full of few odd electrical bits. Apart from that one, it's an empty tray for some reason. Pardon me. And I've got some doodahs in this one. Banged up nose. Oh, Jesus. Feels like I've got something wedged up each nostril. Those are all my screwdriver tips. Oh, and some of my precision screwdrivers. And drill bits, I believe, are underneath. Oh, fucking hell. Pick that lot up and put back in the closet. Right. Someone was supposed to come at 5:30 to collect this. It's now 8:10 in the evening and I've heard nothing and no message or anything. But I did get a message from eBay, because I've got it up on eBay as well, asking if I would consider posting it, and the reason I didn't was because of its bulkiness, but I didn't realise, well as you can see it's now laying flat on that table, I didn't actually realise it came apart in two sections like that. It just clips together. There's one, two, three, four, five metal contacts on there. So, yeah. Take the batteries out, that'll make it a bit lighter. So, I messaged them back and said, yeah, I'd post it. Not a problem. And I put that feature on the advert itself. On the eBay ad, I mean, you know, the postage. It would be $6.85 via my Hermes, and that'd be a 2 to 5 kilogram parcel, I expect. I'll find something to stick it in. Oh, my sinus at the minute feels like there's a vice clamped right on there. Horrible. It's the man flu, that's what I've got, the man flu. I wish I'd known that'd come apart like that earlier, because that would have made storing it a heck of a lot easier. And it can take headphones as well, as a headphone jack under here and whatnot. So, put that back in here. Hopefully now I'll post it. You know, so it might interest more buyers. Tell you what, let's get this bloody blue tub refilled. I should have gone to get my a antidepressants. But with that weather, the high winds and the rain, I kind of said, fuck that. I'll go tomorrow. Put that up there yet, because I need two hands to do that. I'm definitely going to have a soak and a bath later. Nice long soak and a nice hot bath. Right. Oh yeah, I forgot about that, didn't I? I wanted to bring the amplifier I'm going to keep and stick it in here. And keep the pioneer, so let's do that. For a CRT TV, you know, that is actually a pretty damn light. Right. Anyone want to come over and be my nurse? Yeah, I'm going to keep the top one, the Pioneer one. I can't even see it on my screen. Hang on. There. I could see it on my screen. I didn't have my eye close enough to the viewer. Right. So, pull all this crap off. Like I said, it works. It smells a bit hot, so when it's been on for a while, so I'm not sure if it's just perhaps thermal paste on the MOSFETs or something that's getting a little too hot, or gone dry, so they're getting a bit too hot. So it's gone dry, it's not gonna, you know, transfer the heat as well. I've got two cables here and I don't know which one's going to which. Some bloody weight in one of these. Right. Oh. I ain't got a plug on this one. Why haven't I got a plug on? Oh, that's why I haven't got a plug on this one. That's okay. Oh, what a fucking power transformers in these, make them weigh a ton! Hey! There it is. What I'm gonna do, because it does work, and it is a nice looking unit. I have freed up all of these, speaker contacts, because some of them had actually rusted and seized, but they're all working now. All these inputs and whatnot on the back. I've got the earth terminal there, but I'm going to take this off because that's gone rusty on there. So yeah, take this off and just give that a spray up with some black paint. We've got power plugs on the back here for other devices. Yeah, I couldn't bring myself to get rid of that one. I would like to find a way to get it set up and actually in use, but currently I don't actually need it. So that's going to go under there first. I'm going to stick you up there for the moment. Shall I give you a tour of the front first, actually? If I can. Let's just move. Hell, I've folded up this bloody metal detector and I'm still getting in the fucking way. There we go. Here we are. So, I have no idea how old this is yet. I haven't had a look. It's an SA710 according to that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab a piece of paper and just write a note on. I'll write it on the back of this. He says, I'm going to keep it face down because I've got private addresses on the back of this. I don't want to flash those around. So I know it's a Pioneer, but what is it? It's an SA 710, did I say? Yeah, 710. Stereo amplifier. I will just check on the rear. Actually, before I do that, it's got the usual thing. It's got the bass knob there. It's got the speakers. I've never understood with these why you switch between A and B. You can't seem to run both speaker sections at the same time. You can turn them off. Got your treble there as well. Function. So we've got tuner, phono, tape, AUX. Your volume. Balance for your speakers. Tape 2. On, off. Loudness on, off. Mode, stereo, mono. Tone on, off, and subsonic, whatever the hell that is. It was 15 hertz, or whatever that setting is. Quite simple. There is a headphone jack on here. There should be something. Oh no, that's power LED. No, not. Anything on the back? Oh, it is just a model number SA710. Okay. I'll get this in. I need to go and use the toilet. Surprise, surprise. Oh. So, I will talk to you. Well, it's the next day. And, I can't remember why I didn't pick the camera up last night, but I didn't. And I've been out most of the day today. I went to Mum's, we went over to the caravan and done some stuff out there, and my brother has given me one of these. It's only an 8GB one, but we'll see. We'll see if this Sony will accept it. As far as I know, it's a working card. Took its sweet time. Right. Preparing image database file. Please wait. It's worked, and it has given me 34 minutes according to that. Yeah, be enough for now, at least to give it a go. I will get a bigger card, and I was given some links to Amazon yesterday, and for the price of a 32GB card, I think I'm going to go for that one. Oh, that's a damn good picture. Damn good picture. Anyway, let's close that. Still got a rotten cold. Although, the nose isn't blocked up, but the cough is in. I smell cigarette smoke. Why can I smell cigarette smoke? Might be in my clothes. Excuse me. Might be embedded in my clothes as Mum smokes. The guy for the mountain bike turned up when I wasn't here. He said between 10 and 12. So I'd already disappeared after 12. but he did get the bike, he got the bike, and he's left them, or posted the money through my letterbox, so that's good. But I also found something else. Careful, Nemo. Got one of these. Now, I haven't ordered anything or bought anything. Which means it can only be one thing. I had agreed to swap one of my road lamps in the bedroom for another one. For one that I hadn't got. So if that's... It's got to be that, because I, like I said, I've not ordered anything. If it has, now that I've actually come into some money, I can post that. I was going to do it Thursday when I did King Cohen's parcel, but if this guy has already gone to the trouble to post his side of the trade this early, then I'll do mine. But yeah, it's weird. This camera was meant to be signed for and it was left on my doorstep. This isn't signed for, and instead of this is every... It's got to be a different postman, it can't be the same one. Yeah, it's just too large for your letterbox. That's what he's ticked on there. Did he get... Oh, he got my name right this time. He put it as down last time. Cue the bloody cough. Stuff me. I did sleep much better last night though. I think I managed to stay asleep for at least 4 hours solid without waking up, whereas the previous night I was asleep, awake, asleep, awake, asleep, awake, asleep, all bloody night. Which is why I actually got up early, because I was just sick and tired of doing that. I was actually in bed late, as usual, and I actually got up rather early for me anyway. Right, so I'll leave that laying on there on my table. I do plan, in the future, to do some live streaming on YouTube. But for that you need a streaming program. My brother has suggested OBS, and he's shown me what it's like, so I'm going to go and search for that later, and we'll see if I can do anything with that. May not live stream that often, but I'd like to have the option there. Oh, I took my Acer laptop to Mum's today for its first official trial one. Trial run. And works great. Mum's net is a bit slower than mine, but it works great. I can't complain. Got my brother's computer up on the net as well with my little dinky TP-Link USB Wi-Fi adapter. He couldn't believe the size of it when I bought it to him. It's literally the size of one of those little USB wireless mouse receivers. I don't think I've still got that mouse. I think I gave that to my brother. I think. Did I? Well, I haven't seen that mouse around here, so I must have done. Because I did have one at one point. Right. Well, suppose if I check the, going back to the camera, if I check video settings on this and perhaps put them on their lowest, it might give me a bit more filming time, but a little over 30 minutes should do me at least for now. Like I said, I will buy a card. I do think it's funky that this has got a projector on the side. Look. No idea what that does. Well, I presume it projects an image on a plain surface. See, I had a Panasonic camera. I had my Panasonic, but that gave up the ghost on me. I tried to fix it, but that was beyond fixing. Anyway, I've just noticed the battery scale on this is reading pretty much empty. I'm surprised it's not flashing yet. So, I just thought I'd stick the camera on while my computer behind me boots up. And I'll put this on charge in a little while. Well, if I'm going to put this footage to the computer, I'm going to have to use it, because I think it's still plugged in. Yes. Don't know if it's turned on, but it is still plugged in. Before I go, they did click the buy it now on that metal detector, so I've got to post that off as well. Yeah, all's good. Oh yeah, I got that £10 note to stick in my wallet as well. Where did I put my wallet? There it is. It stays in my pocket all the time, because the number of times I've put this down, and every time it comes to payday, I'm running around like a blue-assed fly trying to find this. So, it's in here somewhere, because I can feel it. Oh, hello. I forgot that was in there. 5p. Tired. Anywho, thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget, if you wish to, leave a comment, like, subscribe as well. Thanks to all those that do, and I will talk to you again very soon. Likely tomorrow, because if that parcel's what I think it is, I'm going to want to show it. It's not going to interest everyone, but oddly enough, my road lamp, barricade lamp videos seem to be getting quite a good number of views, at least for my channel anyway. Now, one of my videos that do get the highest number of views. I really don't know why though. I mean, it's a road lamp. They used at roadworks. The videos on these have had quite a large number of views compared to a lot of my other videos. Each to their own, I guess, but like I say, I just make these videos for my channel because it's my interest. So, now, anyone that wants a free one of these, I've got quite a few of these maxi lights. Anyway, ta-ta.